Hi, thank you so much for having me. So I'm going to talk today about editing photos in CSS. And that consists of a couple of things. So I'll be talking about CSS filters, pretty briefly, blend modes, gradients, and then we're going to talk about some fun CSS filter effects. So let's start with the filters themselves. CSS filters, there's 10 of them. There's blur, brightness, contrast, drop shadow, grayscale. Make sure you spell grayscale with an A, not an E, because I make this mistake all the time. There's hue, rotate, invert, opacity, sepia, and saturate. And I'm not going to go over these in too much detail because they're pretty self-explanatory. But they're really powerful, and the adoption of them is pretty wide, so you can get started using them. The only real thing that's lagging behind right now is Internet Explorer and Edge, so make sure if you need to support those, keep in mind. But you can just have one line of code do something pretty powerful. So here, I have a blog post I wrote with all these images, and they have white backgrounds to sort of blend into this layout. But in reality, I created these images on an iPad app called Paper, and the app had this gray background. So see how it's actually gray? Instead of going to Photoshop, there's about 7 images on this page, and editing each image individually, I just had to add one line of code, and it affected all the images on the page and made them white. I just added a little contrast filter, and it was like magic. So super quick, super easy, never had to open Photoshop. You can also animate and transition all of these filters. So I can just hover over this and have, in about 8 lines of code, a transition hue rotation animation that makes this little ball change colors. So filters are really dynamic, great to use, and nice to create effects with. The next is blend modes. And this is a huge topic, but I love seeing blend modes online. An excellent example is the Front End London website. They have a black and white image as the background, so they're actually saving some kilobytes of data with having a smaller image size by using black and white. And on top of that, they have this pink to red gradient fade, so it creates a nice effect. Polygon also shows a site that uses these blend modes in a nice way for their layout. It's a new site. And XOXOFest shows them really dynamically, like you could see the movement in them, and that's really my favorite part of using these blend modes. So there's 2 types of ways that you can really use them. There's mixed blend modes, support is sort of varied. A mixed blend mode affects how the element interacts with other elements on the page behind it. Then there's also the background blend mode, and you can use this on multiple backgrounds when you have multiple backgrounds in a single element. And this won't affect how that element interacts with the page, but it affects how those backgrounds interact with each other. So pretty similar support across those. So let's get started with those. There's a wide variety of blend modes, and I kind of want to dive into how these work. So let's start with darken blend modes. And to help us describe darken blend modes, I will ask Mr. Vanilla Ice here and some vanilla ice cream. So let's overlap these images and then multiply them. The way that multiply works is it literally takes the luminosity, so the light values of the pixels, and multiplies them. You can think of the active layer as A and the background layer as B. And it's taking that luminosity and multiplying A times B. Therefore, the name is multiply. Darken works a little bit differently. So this is actually creating new tones. If you look here, there's a new green color created. It's taking the RGB channel, so it's similar to multiply, but it's taking every channel, looking at which color is darker, which R value, which G value, which B value, and it creates a new color based on every individual channel. And then there's color burn, which uses an algorithm here, so it's a little bit more saturated, a little bit brighter, but the algorithm here is the inversion of the background pixels, so that's 1 minus that luminosity value again, and then we invert that again and divide that by the active layer's luminosity as well. So if you were curious, that is how color burn works. Now let's talk about the light and blend modes. So here we have Drake, and what's better than one Drake is 2 Drakes. So if we overlap that and we screen it, screening images is sort of like the absolute opposite of multiplying them. You're multiplying the lightness values. So instead of doing the luminosity of A times B, we're doing A inverted times B inverted inverted. So we are actually like doing a lot of inversions here. That's how screen works. Lighten is also similar to darken, but again, the opposite. You take the lightest color of each of the RGB channels, and you keep that value, so you're creating new tones here. And then color dodge is a different algorithm, but again, you get this really contrasted sort of effect by color dodge. And the algorithm for that is taking the background's layer luminosity over the inverse of the active layer luminosity. So contrast blend modes we will use. the Arc de Triomphe in Paris and the one in Spain, and then overlap those. These are really interesting because everything in the contrast blend mode group uses a combination of other blend modes. So what Overlay is doing is it's taking Multiply and Screen, and it's taking half of a percentage on those, half strength, and it's using Backdrop to base that on. So Hard Light is doing the same thing, but it's taking the foreground layer. So if we get rid of Hard Light, I can show you what Soft Light is doing. And Soft Light is using both the Darken and Lighten blend modes instead of Multiply and Screen. When we look at comparative blend modes, let's use, this is my friend Harry Roberts, does everyone know who he is? He's CSS Wizardry Online. And let's compare him to my other friend, Drake, here. So let's use Difference and overlap them. So the Difference blend mode, what that does is it subtracts the pixels, luminosity again. And originally it was used for lining up transparencies when you're doing different screen prints. So when the page is completely black, you know that's perfectly aligned. Now, the difference, no pun intended, between difference and exclusion is that with exclusion, those pixels turn gray. The similar pixels are gray instead of turning black. And then we have the last blend mode, which is the composite blend mode. So here we'll use some kittens and some rainbow cupcakes because I don't have any cats in this talk yet. So let's see what Hue does. If you think about it, hue is the color on that color wheel, the hue value. And so we're applying it to those cupcakes. And the cupcakes are adding the color to the kittens. But the kittens are keeping their luminosity, so their brightness value and the saturation. So on top of the kitten's skin, you barely see that rainbow. But around the kittens in the background, you see much more of the color shining through. So for saturation, what you're doing is making the kitten's skin really saturated because you're only taking the brightness, the saturation value from the cupcake, so the bright, saturated red value, orange value, yellow value, and applying that to the kitten. So the eyes become really bright, the skin is this orange color, you can see this outline pretty clearly. With luminosity, what you're doing is taking the black and white values on the cupcakes, but sort of coloring them, you're applying the hue and saturation of the kittens to them. So you get this really creepy like eye coming through on the cupcakes. And then the opposite of that is color. So now we're taking both the hue and saturation of the cupcakes and applying them on the kitten images as though the kitten images are just black and white, and we're coloring it with the hue and saturation of the active layer. So I'm telling you all this because now we're going to talk about some fun CSS image effects. And the first one is the lazy designer method. So this requires two steps. The first one is you apply a blend mode of either multiply or screen on the image. And then you isolate that graphic with contrast filters. So what do I mean by that? Here's the same example that I was showing earlier. And we learned that this image, I need to add a filter of contrast to make sure that the background is perfectly white. And now we're going to do a mixed blend mode of multiply, so that it blends into the background. We can also invert this image to have a different look, and instead of multiply, use screen. So we get the opposite effect. And then we can go and play and add like a hue rotate, like 180 degrees, and see how these colors are changing back here? I'll change it to zero. Like, it went from pink to blue. You can really just dynamically, in your browser, open DevTools and start playing around with it. So here's another little example. This is an image that I took from a rooftop and add this little jumpy hello. But I'm using the same method. So if we really take a look at this, I'll make this background image a little bigger. And you might start to notice that this is starting to look a little strange. We'll remove the blend mode, we'll remove the filter, and it's still the same image there, but it's really just me at a bar drawing a little coaster and holding it up and just really lazily throwing it into my layout. So you can do a lot when you mix filters and blend modes together. Here's another example of that. Here I'm just using the screen blend mode, so the opposite, the second method I showed you, and just throwing that into the page and applying it and having it be a part of that layout. The next effect I'm going to talk about is the vintage washout effect. So that requires the blend mode of lighten, and then we're going to make the background color the shadow color. So instead of a light color for lighten, we're going to use a dark color. And it looks like this. So we lose a little bit of detail here if you look in the trees when it comes to the shadows, and we create this nice like vintage washout effect. No more dark values, but we're providing that darkest value. So what you do is you add the blend mode of lighten, and then I'm using the background blend mode, so I have two backgrounds here, and I'm going to change what the background color is. So if I make it really bright, you see that I'm just blowing out the page. So you want to make a color in the grays, maybe something brown, maybe like a navy or purple, and you get that nice vintage hazy effect. Next effect is the infrared photo effect. If you're familiar, there are sometimes these layouts that you look at, just these photographs of landscapes, and they look a little strange, a little surrealistic. So you can do this with blend modes. The first step is to duplicate the image. The second step is to add the invert filter to the top layer. And then the third step is to use the blend mode of color on the top layer. So the first thing is to invert, and then we get this image. And that looks a little crazy, but then we use the blend mode of color and it makes everything look nicer and zen. So what's going on here is on the left you can see the inverted image and on the right you can see the colored image. Since we're using blend mode of color, it's taking the hue and the saturation of the layer on top of it, but the luminosity, so the lights and dark tones of the image below it, and applying it on top. So it still looks like the color is being transitioned onto this image where the dark and light tones are retaining. So that creates this infrared effect. And you can play with the hue here, like the hue rotation I was showing earlier, and you can get a lot of different, just various effects with these photos. So something else fun to play with in the browser. But let's kick it up a notch with CSS gradients. Just a quick overview on gradients. The basic gradient, I'm using just pink and this purple color here, top to bottom. You can change it to right, to left. You can add degrees, so here's a 20 degree gradient. You can affect the stops, so this one's starting at 10% and the next color starting at 30%. You can make repeating gradients, and then you can make stripes if the first gradient is stopping at the same point that the second gradient is starting. You could do radial gradients. These take the shape of their container, but you can also affect the shape of the gradient. So here I have a circle. I could change the size, make it bigger, make it larger. It's really fun to work with gradients, and they provide multiple colors for your overlays when you're working with blend modes. So here I have no blend mode applied on this image. I'm just going to apply this gradient, but use different blend modes. And it creates all of these really various effects. So it's really fun to just play and see what happens in the browser when I'm applying these individual blend modes. But wait, there's more. Remember back in the days when these blurry background images were really popular? And you would like go on DeviantArt to find them and download them for your site? Well, you can make those yourself if you think about how gradients work and break it up into sections. So I broke this one up. And I could just add a couple of lines of code here, like add a linear gradient from like deep pink to blue, and I want it to go like to right. And then maybe on top of that, I'm gonna have a radial gradient of wheat to transparent, which I use pretty often when I'm making these. So I have that, but maybe I want this to be a circle at the top. So it's starting to look like the image that I have outlined here. And so if you take the time to really grab those colors and to build it, it just takes a few lines to create any sort of blurred background you want. And once you've done this, you can use that to create filter effects, any kind of filters. So here's an example of where I'm using filter effects on a layout. I've applied a very similar filter to the one I just showed you to all the images here. And it really brings this unifying factor. So without it, they're really lacking. Some are blending in the background. But by just using filters and blend modes, I can bring this unifying element to all the images in this page. And because of the cascade, you don't have to open Photoshop. You don't have to do this work. You can just write a couple of lines of code, and the browser does it for you. So I decided to make some Instagram filters because I thought, why not recreate something? That's the best way to learn. And so this is my starter image, an image of my desk in my apartment. And you can recreate rays or inkwell. I just use filters here, not even having to use blend modes. Then I use Perpetua, I only use blend modes. The rest are pretty much a mix of the two. So there's a variety here. There's Lo-Fi, 1977, Brooklyn, X-Pro 2. And I combine these into a library called CSSGram. So you can go and use this as an active development, apply it to your web page. There's a few ways to use it. Highly encourage y'all to participate if you want in open source. But yeah, it's all online and open, just using filters, blend modes, and gradients. So let's review. CSS filters plus CSS blend modes plus CSS gradients are pretty awesome. And CSS is pretty awesome. Like, if I hover over this, in a couple lines of code, I have this hue rotate transition. Like, if I highlight it, it transitions the highlight. Pretty cool. But this is also just the beginning. Like, this is something that I want you to realize. Right now, we're at like basic beginner Super Mario, but soon we're gonna be at Super Mario 3D World as browsers get better at rendering graphics, which is really exciting. So Art the Web, there are tons and tons of different image effects that you can play and work with. I combined a couple of resources that I've been working on over the past couple of months at arttheweb.com. If you want some more information about these, you can get all the demos. I have a couple more demos that I didn't have time to show you. But yeah, check that out, and thank you so much for having me.